Welcome, all friends of the Dhamma. We practice Samatha and Vipassana. And how you know you do Samatha or Vipassana? How you know? Okay? Okay, now we just know Samatha is to calm down the mind. The mind always lost in thought, calm down. But even you calm down the mind, your heart still attached with desire. Your heart is here, attachment. So Vipassana is clear your attachment, clear your heart, free from attachment, okay? Calm down the mind. Or you can say this is mine, but this is conditioning mind, okay? Or monkey mind. Calm down the monkey mind or conditioning mind, calm down. When calm down, then you develop goodness in your heart. Clean your heart with more goodness or wholesome state with letting go. Okay? This is Vipassana. And what you can rely when you got Vipassana? Now just let go everything not here. Let go everything. Let go your job. Let go your family affair. When you let go, you know you are sitting or not? You know you are sitting. Letting go everything from heart. Do you know you are sitting? Okay? And not only know you are sitting, you know you are breathing. From heart. Okay? But if Samatha, you not yet letting go, you cannot letting go or not yet letting go or letting go only some part, then you develop Samatha, but you watch the breathing. Okay? This you see the breathing and calm down the mind. But in your heart, still dark, still emotion, still desire, attachment, still expectation. Okay? So that's why you need to develop Samatha and Vipassana together. Easily, just relax yourself. Before you watch the breathing, relax your heart, relax the body, relax the mind here, okay? Relax. Okay? And now, open your eye. When you relax yourself, you feel comfortable or not? Do you feel comfortable? Open your eye, because I want you to develop seeing from heart, or Vipassana first, and then develop Samatha. Sometimes I teach Samatha first and then Vipassana later. Now Vipassana, you just develop more awareness or feeling. Can you feel you are sitting on the cushion? Can you feel? Can you feel your movement? Can you? And can you feel your heart? You feel your heart. It look like you see something in your heart. Good or bad. Can you feel the right hand? The right shoulder? Just your heart. Intention on the right shoulder. Your eye with me. Intention to know, to feel the right shoulder. Can you feel? If you can feel, you can see. See from your feeling. Can you feel your shirt touching on the right shoulder? Can you see? See by feeling. Can you feel the left shoulder? Okay, your shirt touching on the left shoulder. Or feel cool or hot on the left shoulder. If you can feel, you can see. See from your feeling. Can you feel on the back of the body? Cool, hot, or sweat? Can you see cool, hot, or sweat over the back of the body? Can you see from your feeling? Feeling the back of the body, cool or hot or sweat. Can you realize cool or hot? More realization, it becomes seeing or becomes sensing. Sensing, not by eye looking. Your eye cannot look at the back, But can you sense how you got feeling on the back, cool or hot? Can you sense? This is Vipassana. Okay? Vipassana we see by awareness or sensing. Can you sensing how you sit? How you sit? Okay? How you move? Okay? Sensing. If you don't know sensing, I will take your photo, you will know how to sense yourself. Okay? Now, I tell you group photo. I count one. What you do when I count one? You look at the camera. When I count two, what you do? Smile. When smile, you got feeling or not? You got feeling, then it becomes sensing your face. You can see by feeling, or we call sensing. Smile, can you sense your smile? Can you see your smile by feeling? That is Vipassana. Vipassana, we see by awareness. One, you put concentration on my camera. This is Samatha. I count two, you turn inwards to see body and mind. Now, mind is feeling on your face because you smile. Can you see body and smiling face? Smile. This is Vipassana. And you got calmness. I not count three. You stay there for 1 hour. Smile. Can you sense you're laughing? Can you sense? This is, we can say that you got seeing yourself. Normally, you must watch yourself, how you sit, how you speak. But when you laughing, you can see how you laugh from sensing. So Vipassana, we see inwards. Samatha, we see forwards. Or watching the breath, the breathing, seeing the mind. Okay? If you only watch the breathing, not see the mind, you develop Samatha only. But now you watch the camera again. One, this is Samatha. Two, you smile. When you smile, you got feeling. Your feeling become wake up and sensing. Smile, can you see your smile? If you can see your smile, you can see your body sitting posture. If you can see your smile, you can see the feeling, the thought, the body, the sensation. Because when you can see everything regarding the four foundation. Can you see by sensing? If you can see by sensing, you can see four foundation at one time. Four foundation, that means body sensation and mind, thought or feeling, okay? And then Dhamma or quality of mind. When I look at you, I watch you. I cannot see other people because I watch you. Mm-hmm. But if I just turn back, just see what you are doing, I can see other people also. When you got seeing, your mindfulness awareness wake up. When I see you, I can see everybody. But when I concentrate, put concentration on you, focus you, I cannot see other people. Okay? But when I come back, seeing, I can see more and more everybody. So can you make difference? Look at me and look at master and see master. If you look at master, you can look only master, at only master. If you see master, you can see maybe things around master. That's right. So Vipassana, we develop seeing. But seeing master is seeing outside. How to see yourself? Seeing master is not seeing yourself. How to see yourself? Smile. Smile. Can you see yourself? From consciousness. See by consciousness. Smile. Can you see yourself? And now, relax. Relax. Like when you play sport. When you play sport, your eye look opponent, but you see how you play sport. You don't have to look at the ball, but you can kick the ball because you can see the ball come this way. See, but you look at the opponent. Look at the opponent is samatha. See the ball, see how you swing, see the way you play sport. Vipassana, okay? Seeing, okay? So even you jogging in the morning, can you see yourself? Can? Because when you jogging, you have movement. When you have movement, you got feeling. When you got feeling, it become wake up, see himself, okay? So now, just, okay, move one hand, and you don't look at the hand. Look to the left. Can you feel the movement of the right hand? Feel. If you can feel, you can see. Okay? Now, how to develop seeing? Sometimes moving slowly, sometimes fast, sometimes slowly. Can you see what different? Can you see now moving slowly or fast? Or slowly or fast? Can you see? This is seeing by awareness. Awareness of movement, fast. Can you see it's fast? Awareness of moving slowly, 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 slowly. Can you see it slowly? Okay. And now, can you see your body? For now you just relax. Can you see? Can you see? Not by eye. Try, relax. Can you see? Now, when you relax the whole body, consciousness wake up throughout the whole body. Your eye look thing outside, but your consciousness sensing how you sit, how you walk. How you doing? Can you sense how you doing? How you sit? Can you sense how you sit? How you move? Can? Now you know this is consciousness. Wake up. We call body consciousness. And very important, this body consciousness, very important. My master say, you know, Do you want to know how much you still have rebirth? Do you want to know how much you still have rebirth? My master said, when you lose your body consciousness by eye looking at things and got desire, satisfy desire, you forget consciousness over the body. Your consciousness over the body. Go to the eye, form thought, form desire, form attachment. Now you got one rebirth. And after that, your friend speak good or bad to you. You forget your consciousness. You just enjoy, speak good or not enjoy, angry. They speak bad. One rebirth. And then you have night food, lunchtime. Forget you are sitting and eating. You just knowing eating, but no, don't know you are sitting. One rebirth. Okay? Or you smell nice. You forget feeling over the body. One rebirth. So, how much you got rebirth? You just check yourself. You got rebirth 100,000 of time in a day, in the six channel, eye rebirth, ear rebirth, tongue rebirth, nose rebirth, body contact, nice, soft, I love it. And thought rebirth, thinking, I am superstar, I am that, I am this. You got rebirth in a day, 1,000, a lot. That means you are really far from enlightenment. So now, I just tell you this principle. Just keep consciousness over yourself. The four main posture. Four main posture. Keep consciousness aware. Aware of the four main posture. You will feel more consciousness. Even your eye look, just see. Because you keep consciousness here, before your consciousness gone with the eye, look, not just see, but I love it, I like it, one rebirth, okay? Your ear listen, just feeling consciousness. Consciousness, be conscious, knowing you are sitting. And hearing, just hearing, no rebirth. Be conscious, knowing you are sitting. Seeing, just seeing. Okay? How to practice seeing, just seeing. Hearing, just hearing. Be mindful with good consciousness over yourself. Or be conscious. You are sitting. You looking. You listen to me. One rebirth. Because you forget you are sitting. Okay? So, you look at me. Be conscious. Now you sitting and look at me. No rebirth. I am a monk. No problem. If you see a beautiful girl, well, a lot of problem. Okay? Be conscious. Be conscious. Okay? Be conscious. Seeing, hearing, no rebirth. Be conscious. Okay? Be conscious. That means mindfulness regarding the whole body. Oh, kayakata sati. Lord Buddha teaching anapanasati, mindfulness regarding the breathing. And kayakata sati, mindfulness immersed throughout the whole body. And Lord Buddha say, those who practice mindfulness immersed throughout the whole body, or regarding the whole body. All the four foundations of mindfulness will be fulfilled, okay? All the four foundations, body, feeling, mind quality, all fulfilled. Because you not fail off. You stay with yourself. The mind and the body go together, okay? Not fail off. Your mind always fail off or go out, fail off. Go out, traveling out or fall asleep or fill up in the emotion. You just keep conscious. Be conscious knowing how you sit, knowing how you walk, okay? Knowing how. I stress knowing how. Now, you got a lot of rebirth when you practice meditation. You try to follow the breathing. You know the breath. But you don't know the breathing. You know the breath. But how the breathing? How the feeling of the breathing? You have very poor awareness. Because you put more and more concentration on the breathing. Then you forget consciousness. Consciousness of what? Of the breathing. Because the breathing got two parts, the breathing. One part we call the breath body. You concentration on the breath body. But you forget the abstract, the feeling of breathing. That's why I just tell you, watch the breath and know how breathing going together. Watching the breath and know how breathing. Now no rebirth. Now many practitioners fail up, okay? Attach more concentration without consciousness, without awareness of what you are concentrating. you will be more attached. So if you feel together, and now, don't watch the breathing, watch me instead. Can you feel your breathing? Can?
Still feeling.
Still feeling, that's right?
Yeah.
That's good.
Oh, okay.
Still feeling, that's right? This we call awareness of breathing. And in awareness of breathing, now you say, in awareness of breathing, just watch. It is breathing in or it is breathing out? In awareness of breathing, can you do? So you got two qualities. Watching, that is mindfulness. Awareness or feeling is awareness. You develop two qualities together. So I just want you to check yourself. How you doing? You wash the bread, but the bread is you wash the bread. You wash only the bread body here. But the feeling of breathing is not only here. It go in deeply. Okay? So you must know with good awareness together. That means I tell you awareness first, because to put concentration is easy, okay? But when you put concentration, then you forget, always forget awareness. So awareness first. So today I will teach you anapanasati, starting from awareness, okay? To correct yourself, because you starting from concentration, that is your mind to focus, okay? But in daily life, you cannot practice anapanasati with concentration, because you have to put concentration on the job, okay? So now awareness first. Can you look far, but just realize from your heart, are you still alive? Oh, sorry, you are alive. Are you still breathing? Yeah. Can you realize from heart? You still breathing? This is awareness. Something, pew, pew, pew. Okay? Awareness. This is very important. Again, just not focus me, just see, but sitting aloud, but together, just aware you are breathing, how you breathing, how, you still breathing or not, and how, just aware. When you awareness of your breathing, how to develop more awareness. Awareness and feel it, because when you feel your breathing, it will be have good awareness. When you feel, can you feel your breathing? How soft, beautiful breathing in, can you feel? Feel what you got. When you feel the breathing even shallow, but it go very deep, because you breathe into your feeling, not only breathe into your lung, okay? Smile, everybody smile. When you smile, you don't have to try to breathing in long. But when you smile, you feel breathing in long, because your smile open up your heart. You got breathing go into your heart. Before you breathing into your lung, and you try to breathing in long but not smile, okay? Breathing out long, not smile. You just do exercise, like gymnastic or like Olympic athlete. Breathing in long, breathing out long. We not play athlete or any competition Olympic who can breathing in long. No, we just relax and smile. Breathing, when you smile, heart open. your breathing go deeper. Even you breathing a little, but you feel good. Okay? That is breathing it long this way. You make misunderstanding. You try to force the breathing. Breathing it long. Oh, head end. Oh. How long? Oh, you force the breathing. How? Smile. And happy in your heart, happiness. Joy and happiness in your heart. Breathing become longer. That's right. Relax in your heart. Can you feel breathing become longer? Because your heart relax is open. And the breathing go into the feeling, not only go into the body. The body. Oh, even you breathing in long, but you cannot stay there for long. But if you just relax and smile, breathing in doesn't matter, even it's shallow, but it become long. Smile. Okay? It become longer. And now, 99% cannot go to the third state of anapanasati. All practitioner can do only the first step and the second step. First step is knowing the breathing in and out long. The second step, knowing the breathing in and out short. But I rarely or seldom see even one can go to the third step. Third step is know the whole breathing. Whole breath, whole breathing. Inside. Now you just follow me. Don't use your thought to criticize. Okay? Just smile. How you feel? You feel good with body? You feel good with breathing? More smile. You feel the breathing, not only the breath body, it become energy. Energy. Breathing energy. Okay? It become qi, you know qi. Qi in Chinese, breathing energy. Okay? From the breath body, it become qi. Life energy. Life breathing. What you say anyhow? Life breathing qi. Or breathing energy. Can you feel when you happy? Breathing go throughout more and more. The whole body. That's right. Just not focus. If you focus, this breathing come out here. Okay? When you focus the breathing, the first and the second step, then more awareness. More awareness until the breathing here disappear, but you still got breathing inside. Because you still alive, you got breathing. Breathing never disappear. Okay? But disappear because you fall asleep. You focus until you fall asleep. Then you thought breathing disappear. Okay? Breathing never disappear. You go to look at Anapanasati Sutta, 16 states. 16 states, the Buddha say, from the first state to 16 states, ending with breathing in, no. Breathing in, you know. Breathing out, you know. Okay? Every 16 step, the Buddha will say in the ending, breathing in, even in the Kaya Nupassana, Vedana Nupassana, Chitta Nupassana, Dhamma Nupassana, ending with the word, breathing in, you know. Breathing out, you know. But now people thought breathing must disappear, then they go deep into the jhana. No, if you have awareness of breathing together, you can go not only deep, but wake up in the jhana. Most go deep in the jhana, deep in the calmness, but not wake up. But you got knowing breathing a bit. Awareness, not focus, but aware. Then you will be wake up in the calmness. For example, now, even you listen to me, Just aware a bit. You are breathing or not? What you got? If you are aware of your breathing a bit, you will not be angry. You will not lost in anger, desire, or attachment. But whenever you got awareness, your breathing become rough and strong. Now that is the indicator to see that you will be angry, okay? So awareness of your breathing a bit by smiling, by relax in your heart. You will realize that you don't have to control your emotion because your breathing is good. You cannot have bad emotion. You cannot have anger because your breathing is smooth. Whenever your breathing become not smooth, now not talk to people, just leave away. Otherwise you will be angry, okay? So you develop awareness of your breathing. And it look like you can see your emotion also when you are aware of your breathing, that's right? When you just know you are breathing, you aware of your emotion is still good, is still nice, okay? So you got seeing. Seeing by awareness, we call Dhamma eye. Now you have only third eye to watch inside. You don't have Dhamma eye. Dhamma eye is inside meditation. What can you say? You don't have third Dhamma eye. Because the way most who practice by concentration on the breathing, after finish meditation, anger still there. Okay? I also still upset, angry before because I have a strong concentration on the breathing. But I found out that why? I got more anger. I practice meditation, but I got more anger. You know? Then I correct myself by reading what the Buddha said. Buddha said, knowing clearly, now you are breathing in long. Knowing clearly, now you are breathing out long. This is awareness, knowing clearly. The Buddha never said, concentration on the breathing in long, concentration on the breathing out long. No. This is the Western translated by himself in the Bali, use the word knowing clearly, clearly knowing. So different version, practice meditation in Asian, we practice by heart. Practice meditation in Western, they practice by mind concentration. different thing, okay? So now just learn something maybe you never learn. Just aware you are breathing, then you not lose temper. That's right. And just aware you are breathing, you can feel breathing so soft, so beautiful, so subtle in your feeling. And your feeling going can go throughout the whole body or not? Can you feel your leg? Can you feel? Can you feel your cushion? Can you feel your arm, your head. So with good awareness, with relaxation of the body, whole awareness of the body, with feeling from heart, will bring your breathing in even shallow, but spreading throughout the whole body. It look like you got absorbed, breathing got absorbed throughout the whole body. Just aware of the breathing with smiling heart. Can you realize breathing going everywhere in the body? This is the third state of anapanasati. Only maybe 0.1% of practitioner can realize this one because no translation in the book, okay? Just by experience, okay? So now what happened? Now I bring you to the third step first because you are well trained in concentration. That is only the first step and the second step concentration. Up to you if you want to concentrate. But to convert to the third state, you must concentration on the breathing from the beginning, from awareness together. Can you watch the breathing and feel the breathing together? Can? You must do this way. Watch the breathing, feel the breathing. Watch the breathing, even long or short, feel the breathing. Then you can rely more awareness, more seeing from heart. Watch and see from heart when you are aware. And when you are aware of the breathing, you not only see the breathing. You can see something good or bad in your heart also. That's right. Can you watch the breathing and see the breathing together and feel? Watch the breathing the way you watch before, but today, add up. Feel together. Develop more awareness. And now, you watch me, watch Master. But can you watch me and together feel your breathing? Can you? You got what? You got seeing. You watch me, but you watch me and inside you feel the breathing. Inside you got seeing. Seeing from inside. Seeing good feeling in your heart. Feeling relaxed, you can see. And now just keep feel the breathing. Just know you are breathing. What happened? You will not try to force the breathing. That's right. What happened when you not try to force the breathing? Your feeling become expanding. Before you try to force the breathing, okay? Your feeling become rough, attached, okay? And disturbed. But now just know I am breathing. You just know you are breathing. Your feeling become open. And what happening up? You got joy and happiness in your heart because you're feeling open. Joy and happiness may be before you take 10, 15 minutes to get joy and happiness. But joy and happiness not from the mind here in the brain, it's from heart. It takes long time because you put a lot concentration, but with poor awareness. But today I tell you straight, more awareness of the breathing. Immediately you got joy and happiness from heart. Okay? When you got joy and happiness from heart, also still feel your breathing from heart, aware of your breathing. Normally when you have joy and happiness, you forgot breathing, and you stay at joy and happiness and not go further, okay? But now, even joy and happiness come up, just know you are breathing. Joy and happiness come up, you just know you are breathing. Then, what happened? More wake up inside. Equanimity of mind. Before you may be attached to joy and happiness for the whole period of meditation. But now, just following the Buddha teaching, what happening? Know your breathing. Then when you know your breathing, you can see joy and happiness there, but you're not attached. Joy and happiness is the object of knowing. But when you aware of breathing, more and more it becomes the knower inside. Wake up. The knower become equanimous, equanimity of mind. And before you got equanimity of mind, you forgot your breathing again. Then you got only equanimity of mind, sabai-sabai, sư-sư, sơ-sơ, ไปเรื่อย. เฉยเฉย. In Thai, we call เฉยเฉย, เฉยเฉย. That is not equanimity of mind. They say เฉยเฉย, เฉยเฉย, ไม่มีอะไร, เฉยเฉย. Because you lost. You lost in the equanimity of mind, you don't aware of breathing. when you aware of breathing, not chui chui, not su su, not chui chui, it become wake up. Wake up like equanimity turn over, becoming a mirror. You know a mirror? Gajok, ngao sai le. A mirror, mirror. A mirror with good exposure, seeing the mental quality inside. When you got equanimity of mind, you don't see anything. Only equanimity of mind, sabai, sabai. But you don't see anything. But now you still keep knowing you are breathing. Just know you are breathing. Don't focus the breathing. Just know. Then the knower, the heart, the knower, wake up, become a mirror. Become eye of Dhamma, seeing equanimity of mind. And equanimity of my life, a mirror to see something more fine and subtle in the heart. That is mental quality. Okay? Now you got equanimity of mind and you still know you are breathing. What happened? You can see mental quality of mind, good or bad, wholesome or unwholesome. And now just know you are breathing also. Keep knowing you are breathing. Knowing, knowing, knowing. It become more knowing and seeing. Knowing and seeing. Knowing and seeing. Knowing and seeing. Seeing, 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 seeing. Until seeing all dirtiness gradually gone or disappear. And seeing more goodness, more wholesomeness come up. Okay, because in the pure mind, in the nature of mind, of all being, it's nice, clear, and pure, okay? But because of ignorance, make you cloudy, okay? Make you lost the way, okay? Now, when you know you're breathing, you still mindful and aware inside. You can go further. You can go further. Seeing and letting go. Unwholesome state, one by one, gradually, gradually. Oh, you just rely. Oh, this we call anger. Oh, I got anger. It release. Before you angry, but you don't see anger. But when you got equanimity of mind, and you still know you're breathing. Oh, this is anger, I thought. I have loving kindness mind. Oh, but I still got anger. Okay? And just know you are breathing, don't worry. When you know you're breathing, you are here at the present moment. Anger release. Release. And when you are aware of your breathing, your eye with me. Because when your eye not with me, you fall asleep. Open eye. Because now we go deep. I bring you deep into the nature of mind. It look like you want to fall asleep when you go deep. Okay? Okay? So open your eye. Now, your eye with me. Your eye is the mirror of your heart. When your eye open, your heart open. When your eye look sleepy, your heart sleepy. Okay? Just wake up your eye first, okay? Hey, you go, mine, huh? Hey, you go, mine, okay? And your heart open, okay? Your heart see more thing inside. Hey, you go. Ask him, not ask you. Hey, you go. Mine is here. Hey, you go, my boy. Hey, you go, mine. Where are you? You sleep for a long night. Here you go. Wake up. Wake up. He wake up. You have naughty boy inside. Now become good boy. Naughty boy. Sleeping boy all the time. Here you go. Here you go. Okay? Wake up. Okay? Now, he wake up in the bush. I was in the bush in Australia before. I know, hey girl. You wake up in the bush. Oh, my dad. You are sitting. I don't know. I always sleep. Now your boy wake up. Wake up with eye of Dhamma. Seeing inside. Oh, I fall asleep with anger. I fall asleep with desire. I fall asleep with attachment. Something had left, but I don't want to left. Okay? Had left. I don't want to leave it. I still take it. Hold it for a month, a year. Oh, I know. I see. Hand left. Now, I must left immediately. Okay? Now, he wake up. And just know you are breathing only. He wake up more and more. But keep time. In this state, you need to keep time. Because you go into the mental quality. Okay? Keep time. Like he just wake up, blah, blah, blah. Just clean eye. Know you're breathing. Just fresh up. Okay? Fresh up. He fresh up already. And he has energy to release all attachment. Release all anger now. Release all desire. He realized, oh, how come I take all this heart in my heart. Desire is heart. Anger is heart. Now I can release. You can realize now. Everybody release heart. Now air condition not work. Because all heart from your desire release. Got sweat now. Everybody release. This is we call Dhammanupassana. Dhammanupassana, you see releasement. Your son release, and you keep knowing breathing. You can see now your son or mind, your mind become good mind now and release on hot regarding desire, attachment. You can feel in this state. You can feel now your body sweat a bit, okay? Because you accumulate a lot in your heart. But Lord Buddha said, anapanasati or breathing meditation can calm down the mind, okay? Can calm down the body and the mind. Now you got into the calmness of mind. When you release, first you feel it hard, but after that you feel really light, really light, okay? Your heart feeling very light now. And just know you are breathing because you still have a lot in your heart. Just know you are breathing, it become aware, like a little child, where, when newborn, where, okay? aware. Oh, God, release. Now you not see by physical eye, you see by awareness inside. Awareness inside we call Dhamma eye. Okay? Dhamma eye. Okay? Eye of understanding. Okay? You got eye of the understanding to understand yourself deep inside. What defining you got? Okay? What residue you got? Then you release. And you still know. Just now you are still breathing. Can you know? Don't worry how much anger you got. Okay, I know I have a lot of anger, but okay, today maybe some release, okay? Just know you are breathing. When you not expect, your anger sometimes gone completely. But if you expect to release, it's very happy. Not expect. Just enjoy your breathing. Enjoy your breathing. When you enjoy, you are breathing or knowing you are breathing, okay? I drinking, I know my breathing also. Then awareness inside more wake up. Or the awakened one is inside. Now when you got more knowing you are breathing, you go to the awakened one. You go to the awakened one and what happening? You got freedom of mind now in your heart. Freedom of mind in your heart. Now just know you are breathing with the freedom of mind in your heart. freedom of desire and attachment. In Samatha level, you've got freedom of thought. In Vipassana level, we have freedom of desire and attachment. Now, how I can explain how you can get freedom of desire and attachment? Because you choose to know your breathing. Then you move from the moody, the bad mood, and to stay with the breathing. Then it's still there, the bad mood, but you not stay with them, okay? You stay with good breathing. Then on moody gone, okay? Freedom of mind there. So now you know this is 16 state of Anapanasana state complete in 15 minutes already. This 16 state. So that's why most practitioners got stuck only in concentration. Concentration can bring you to only focus the breathing in long, out long, focus the breathing in short, out short, only two states only, okay? But to go to the third state, you need awareness, wake up more and more. But you need to develop together. How? I will give you the way to practice. You watch the breathing as you watch, but you must watch the breathing, the breath body, the breathing in the other side, the feeling, okay? Can you watch the breath body and the feeling of the breathing? Expand your mindfulness, okay? When you expand your mindfulness, expand your concentration, see one object, but one object has some quality. Before you not see the quality, you see only the breath body. Okay? One pointiness, one object. Here, now we see one thing, but some quality inside. Okay? Can you watch the breathing and the feeling? Your eye look. Your mind watch. Can? If you don't know how to watch from your mind, because you not able to separate the mind from the eye, so move your finger again, two finger. Move your finger. Your eye look at me, but move your finger under the chin. Your eye look at me. Even your eye look at me, something watch. Watch the finger movement. There is something watching the finger movement. That is your mind, okay? And how you know your mind? Because he's so clever. Even you move slowly, he become more mindfulness. More slowly, more mindfulness. And he's so clever because he can see himself. The knower can see the knower. The knower watch the finger movement, watch and see himself. Watch when it touch, nearly touch. Himself become one pointiness. And when separate, he can see himself more letting go, more letting go, more awareness, more relax, okay? And if you aim to move the finger to touch each other, he got more concentration from the mind, okay? More concentration, not from the brain. It's inside, not outside. Not in front, it back again. Look and watch and see. I have three words. If you understand well three words, you already got my certificate. Sign up for you, okay? Look, watch, see. Can you do together? Look at master. Watch the finger movement, seeing the mind. Look at master, watch the finger movement, seeing the mind. Seeing the mind, what happened in the mind when you watch the finger movement. When you watch the finger movement slowly, in the mind, come up mindfulness more and more. And when you aim to touch, or nearly touch, okay? In the mind got stillness, Okay? Can you see stillness in the mind? And when you touch and you move outwards again, it become more relaxed, more awareness. Can you see in the mind? Quality of the mind. Look master at master. Watch the finger movement and see the mind. Again, can you look at me and watch in your mouth? Can you watch the movement in your mouth? Can. And can you see who is watching? The knower. That is, you must put, if you use the word concentration, you must concentrate deep from the knower, not from here. Just go back. For example, now, watch in your mouth. Can you watch the water in your mouth? Can? The eye cannot look at the water in your mouth, but the mind can. Can you watch the temperature in your mouth? If you can, then how about watch your breathing from him? Watch breathing from him, from the knower, from the pure mind, not from the monkey mind, thinking now I am breathing in, thinking now I am breathing out, thinking now I am breathing it long. You use your thinking, okay? You must watch without thought. Watch from him again, what in your mouth? No thought. He knows exactly you are chewing, eating, movement. Okay? And he can watch more abstract. Watch the temperature in your mouth. Watch the liquid or water element. That's right. And he can watch from top view. You breathing in long and deep. He can watch from top view. That's right. Normally, you watch from your brain. You must grant or put concentration from the eye. You do meditation from the brain. You never do meditation even from the mind. Okay? But now, can you look straight but watch top view on your breathing? When you watch top view, that is the mind. The eye only watch thing in front. If you want to watch top view, the eye must look on the top view, okay? But now you look in front, at the same time, can you watch top view? And not helping from the eye, just watch top view together when you look in front. Top view into your breathing, how or where it's going, long or short, can you watch? If you can watch from the mind, the knower become clear and wake up and emptiness. If you watch from the brain, you got a lot of tension, okay? Watch from the mind. Can you watch the hand movement again? Look to the left. If you watch from the mind, you can watch the movement and the stop. Can you watch the stop? Stop and movement. Movement and stop. And when you watch from the mind will be able to see the mind itself. When you watch the movement, what you see in the mind itself? Awareness, mindfulness. And when you watch your stop, what do you see in the mind itself? Stillness, okay? Or stop. And now look at me, you know how to watch. Watch the movement again, one hand movement. Can you watch the hand movement and the stop? When you watch the stop, the mind stop. Stop. stop completely, stop thinking. When you watch a moment, the mind maybe got some thought. But when you watch the stop together, the mind stop thinking completely. When you watch the moment, now no thought, it become more awareness, more mindfulness. But when you watch the stop, it more awakened, more awakened. When you watch the moment, it's more awareness, more mindfulness. When you watch the stop, it's more awakened. And watch the moment again, it's more awareness. And now, it got every moment stop or not? Can you watch moment stop, moment stop? It got more sharp mindfulness inside. Now, that's why what we practice, even breathing meditation or rising falling of stomach, we not focus the breath body. We focus the movement and the stop of the breathing. Now, instead of focus the breath body, focus on the breathing or the movement. And the moment the breathing in got stop or not? When you watch the breathing in and stop, what happened? Your mind stop. Okay? When you watch the breathing out, normally you follow the breathing out, then you make mistake. You just stay at the stop and see. We develop seeing. When more stop, you got more seeing. Seeing now it breathing out, but the mind not move. The breathing move, the mind not move. And when you breathing in again, the point that you breathing in and before breathing out, it got a pause for 2 seconds. That is the access into meditation. Can you see the pause in between breathing in and out? Try. And stay there at the pause. You can go into stillness of mind in, for me, in 3 seconds or 2 seconds. Okay, for you maybe today less than 1 minute. Okay? Can you see the stop of the breathing in? So you make mistake, you focus the breathing. No, you focus the breath body. Okay, you can focus the breath body, but you must see the breathing, that means the movement and stop. Okay? Again, now we can try for 2 minutes. Watch the breath, but see the breathing. Okay? And cross your eye. And even you open your eye, can you watch the breathing? We not, if we open eye and working, we don't have to focus the breath, but we just watching, we are breathing. Okay? Can you watch yourself? You are breathing enough. If you watch the breath, you cannot work. Okay? If you watch the breath body, you cannot work. But you can watch the breathing, can? But today, if you want Vipassana, now you watch, but I tell you, Vipassana, we got seeing. Now we come to Vipassana. Okay, watch master. Watch master. But do you know you are breathing or not? Yeah. When you know, you got seeing. Seeing from knowing. Okay? This we call seeing from awareness. When you watch, you got seeing. seeing from mindfulness. Watch will bring your mindfulness wake up. So seeing by watching, we call seeing from mindfulness. But the other side, that means inside, if you just aware of yourself, you are sitting, you will see how you sit. Aware of how you dress. Now dress yourself. Aware of how you dress. You will see how you dress. That's right. Awareness of how you clean your face. You will sense yourself, seeing by sensing. So this is Vipassana. But you can develop together. Watch and see together. Watch yourself, see yourself. Watch yourself will develop more power of mind. See yourself will develop more understanding, more awareness. You can develop both together. So that's why I teach you both together. Okay, can you look? Now can you make three things together? Look at your friend, watch yourself, and know how you breathing. Can you? Watch yourself, know how you breathing. Even you talk to friend, you look at thing. Okay? Yeah, this way, naturally. Naturally, your mindfulness gone, your awareness gone, because you never turn inwards. How to turn inwards? Turn inwards, knowing yourself, seeing yourself. How to know yourself, see yourself? For starting, just watch yourself, see yourself from mindfulness. Observe. Okay? And then, can you look at people but observe how you speak? Can you talk to people? Observe how you speak, how you work with people, and observe how you work. Can you? This is you got mindfulness. But observe yourself is not enough. Sometimes you still disturbed or angry. Okay? So observe yourself and aware. How are you today? How you doing? Generally first, if you not have a skill, just aware generally how you doing. But when you have more skill, you can rely how you doing and breathing still good, still okay. When you listen to me, you can realize breathing is still good because you listen to mom. If you listen to a politician, maybe breathing not good. Okay? That's right? So you can, at the time, your mind got thing to know. It depends on how much quality you can develop. At least two quality. You must develop mindfulness and awareness. At a time you seeing or looking or listening. Before you lost both mindfulness and awareness. But now I tell you must develop at least two quality. Listen with mindfulness, watch yourself, awareness, know yourself. It's simple. Know yourself, watch yourself. Know yourself, watch yourself until seeing happening, seeing yourself. Two quality. You told me how to develop two quality in mindfulness and awareness, but you don't have to ask me when you angry, how develop unwholesome state, how many unwholesome state, not only angry, jealous, moody, selfish, and suffering. When you do bad, you hold all unwholesome state, many things together. But when you want to do good, ask me, Master, I just do mindfulness, or I just do awareness. When you do good, why you choose one by one? When you do bad, you like bring everything together. When you do good, Master, I should do meditation or I should do mindfulness. Oh, why? You must do all goodness together, at least five. The power in meditation, there are five. We call five faculties. five faculties. The first one is trust or belief in the Buddha. Okay? This one may be hard for the Westerner, but for Asian people, very simple. Trust in the Buddha, faith in the Buddha. Because if you don't have faith in the Buddha, your mindfulness, your concentration will go outside only. Look outside, see outside. But when you trust in the Buddha, okay, faith in the Buddha, your mindfulness will turn inwards to see your mind itself. Okay? Or if you do meditation, you don't have trust in the Buddha, you only object, focus on the object. We call momentary concentration outside. But actually, when you got momentary concentration, okay, there is a knower who know the object, but you cannot rely because you never have faith in the Buddha. When you have faith in the Buddha, when you look at things, you can rely the knower inside. Okay? There is a knower inside. How to develop the knower inside? First, you just know this principle. The knower will come up when you got thing to know, when you have object to know. For example, if you don't know anything, you just blah, 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 blah. Now you lost in thought. But if you listen to me, pay attention to me, my voice is your object of meditation. But who know my voice? Inside. Okay? Inside. You can realize easily. I speak loud. But I tell you, can you hear some quiet voice in this room? Inside. Ear, just the channel. But you got hearing from inside. Can you hear some quiet voice in this room? It got my place inside. That's right. So now you watch the breathing. And who know the breathing? Now you have doubt who know the breathing. But now I tell you, when you hear quiet voice, there is something inside. Now you watch the breathing. If you watch the breathing naturally, not forced, let it be. Because when you force, the knower become attached. You cannot find the knower. Okay? When you're not attached, let it be natural breathing. There is a knower inside. And the knower inside, that is the access into the pure mind, okay? But the knower inside need momentary concentration of the object, or the object outside. When you got object for concentration, then you got the knower. If you don't have any object, for example, you have no job, you lose job, you hanging on the hang no, oh, maybe blur all day, but now lucky you have job. You doing job, that is you have meditation. If you don't have job, now you kill yourself. You will be drunken mind, monkey mind all day, whole day, okay? But when you have job, you mind got thing to know, mind will be wake up. You are lucky, not only earning money, but you lucky, you not damage yourself. You develop your mind by working, okay? If you not work, then your mind maybe not develop, or maybe go to hell, okay? Go to hell. And now, I just tell you where is the Nova. Where is the Nova? Now, you lost in thought, but if I tell you chanting Namo, Namo, Namo in your mind, Namo. And you just watch the rhythm of Namo. Na is short, Mo is long. Can you watch in your mind? Namo. Not in your mouth, in your mind. Voice is come from the mind, but your mouth speak, but it come from the mind. Na. Can you watch? Na. Mo. Na. Mo. Na. Mo. You got emptiness already. So this we call the knower. The knower is emptiness. So you ask me where the knower. The knower no shape, no form. The knower is the mind. Mind is empty. When you you got empty or not? Emptiness of mind. And who know emptiness. Because of emptiness, you know and you know more. But if you lost in thought, namo tassa, you lost in thought, you thinking, you don't know, you are chanting, chanting by mouth, but you don't know, namo tassa, you lost in thought. But if you know, namo tassa, you just make a rhythm, okay? Namo together, namo tassa. Bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. You can see emptiness inside. You don't have to practice meditation, but you are mindful, knowing, seeing every rhythm. The knower wake up. The knower there, vipassana there. The knower there, samatha there. If you not find the knower, you don't have samatha or vipassana. When you stay with the knower, you already become samatha and vipassana by itself. Because the knower emptiness. Because of emptiness, you know things as they are. Okay? Namo tassa bhagavato arahato. And now the same knower or not? When you watch inside your mouth movement, chewing. Who was the knower, and how you don't know the knower is emptiness. Okay? You watch from emptiness inside. And now can you watch the breathing from emptiness? So that means, that's why I tell you, can you make three different things? Look at master, watch your breathing, see emptiness in your mind. When you watch your breathing, now even your eye look at your master, you not pay attention to master already. You open your eye, but actually you watch your breathing. So can you watch and see? Watch the breathing and see calmness. Watch the breathing continuously every moment. Calmness become emptiness. And watch the breathing and see calmness. Watch more every moment, you can see emptiness. So now you know breathing in emptiness. You see breathing in emptiness. This is vipassana. Knowing and seeing in emptiness, knowing and seeing in calmness is vipassana. Okay? But if calmness only, because you don't have wisdom, you don't know, nobody tell you to see the knower, then you just stay in the emptiness, calmness, but you never know, you must see the knower, okay? Then if you not see the knower, you got only calmness, samatha only. So now, when you watch me, okay, you pay attention to me, can you see with your wisdom what quality your mind got? When you watch me, your mind come back. When you pay attention to me, every word, every word I talk, Dhamma, talk Samadhi, Vipassana, you listen every word, your mind become clear knowing. Okay? Can you see clear knowing in your mind? Watch outside, see inside. So you train in daily life, watch your friend, see your mind. Watch your job, see your mind. Okay? Watch your job. See your mind. Watch your Facebook. See your mind. Can you? may be difficult. Okay, okay, just okay. Watch and see. Watch and see. Okay.
Isn't mean that we not concentrate on our job?
Concentrate from the mind watching.
So you concentrate on your mind.
From the mind.
Not on your job.
That mean meditation on the knower, not meditation on the object. If you meditate on the dark object, you can do meditation, work on the job for 1 hour, you tired. But if you meditation on the knower and doing job, you can have good meditation whole day, not tired. I write meditation. I stay with my knower, watching every word I typing. I not watch my typing, but I know clearly from my knower, and my knower watch my typing, and my knower can see wisdom come up from my knower, and then I can type the whole night. Sometimes I write my dissertation the whole night, five days, 6 days, 7 days. Many times I work on my dissertation, my thesis the whole night, because I have good meditation. Good meditation not in front, it's behind. You can try now. Most people misunderstand good meditation, but see clearly. Not good. Meditation must be smart, smile, calm. Okay? Now most make mistake. Meditation in the brain, not in the mind. The mind, not the brain. Okay, that is the same place, but in different plane. Okay, different plane. So where is your mind now? Namo, namo, namo. Can see thought. Before you think thought is your mind. Okay, you correct in some part, but actually mind is emptiness because of emptiness, it can see thought. Okay? So it can see breathing also. And now, if you know this namo, 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 how many seconds? 3 seconds. Usually, you do meditation, closing your eye immediately. The first start, it mean the success or not success. If you first start with thought, close your eye. Oh, now you have a lot of thought. If you just clear your mind, just namo, namo, until your mind apart from thought, back to the knower. Okay? Then thought gone. Your mind can see thought gone. Then your mind can see breathing in. Can see breathing out. Even you not close your eye, you already got into deep state of meditation already. Okay? Good start meaning a lot. But if you bad start, you still have a lot of thought, then you close your eye. Now you fight with thought. Okay? Or you feel sleepy and you do meditation. You fall asleep in 1 minute. But if you brush up, warm up. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Then you will got awareness in your mind, the body movement, and you can see the whole body movement, and you can be aware of in the whole movement there is a breathing movement. And you watch the breathing, okay? Know the breathing, watch the breathing. Then you will get only maybe 10 seconds to go already into meditation. You never get into meditation in 10 seconds. Maybe 10 minutes still difficult for you, huh? But today in 10 seconds. Oh, the other technique I give you. Just not blinking your eye for 5 to 10 seconds. How? Look widely, like you look at the ocean, look at the sky. Now look at the grass, the white. White it. And not blinking your eye. From looking, when you're not blinking your eye, it turns inward, becomes seeing. From seeing, the mind, pure mind, wake up. That is your home. You must stay. You know where to stay in meditation already. That's right. When you look, and then you're not blinking your eye, then inside wake up, and you stay inside, seeing. Oh, you look in front. Can you see people in this room together? See surrounding? See things around? Can you? You go at seeing, not stay at looking. You stay at seeing. Where seeing from? Inside. Seeing what it mean. What does it mean? When you have people working for you, accountant, they do accounting. They just employee, okay? They do accounting. They just look at the figure. But you are boss. If you do accounting, you not only look at the figure, you will see something mistake or something not good. The figure the same, but this figure you can see more than the figure. You can see this is something, there is something stealing or not, something lost or not. Okay, that's right. So seeing, because you are employee not see, just look at the figure enough, but you will see more than the figure. Okay, you will see something behind. Now you can see something that I cannot see. Can you look and you can see thing around? Your eye cannot see around, okay? But can you see around? I give you radar, satellite, see around, okay? And stay at seeing. This is we call jhana. When you watch, you develop jhana. When you seeing, you develop jhana. So you develop samatha and vipassana together. Look and see. And how to look and see? Watch yourself. Watch yourself. Then you can see yourself. Watch yourself. You can see yourself. And what can you see more? You can see not only the body. You can see feeling of yourself. And what you can see more? You cannot only, you not only see the feeling of yourself, you can see the quality of the feeling. This is the efficiency of your seeing, okay, to contemplate. Okay, now we break for this session and then relax 10 minutes and come back for question and answer. Okay, thank you so much.
Dhamma books here for you to explore as well. So enjoy. Thank you. Thank you.